Hello, I'm Teresa Llano. I'm from Sensi Lab at Monash University, and I will talk today about explainable computation and creativity. Imagine a team of people collaborating towards a common goal. What if they didn't talk to each other, but rather they just proposed ideas without any regard about what other members of the team have in mind? Most probably, the team would fail in achieving a successful result. When people work together, they not only present a final product to their collaborators, they discuss their ideas, communicate their intentions, discuss their influences, compare their thoughts to previous work, among other activities they carry out. There is an explicit or implicit communication between the collaborators. However, with most created systems, there is a common challenge for users and researchers, and is that most of these systems behave as black boxes, limited to pack interactions where processes and reasoning are mostly unknown or obscure. And in the same way, the thought process of the user is also unknown by these systems. As a result, users are left questioning the nature of the system's decisions, or are even discouraged to the notion of collaborating with them, and the full potential of a system-generated idea is not unleashed. These limitations have raised the need for the development of models that offer more clarity and transparency in order to improve the potential for human-machine interactions with CC systems. Take, for instance, this example of music improvisation with an AI system, in which visual cues are used as a means of communication to keep things flowing within the performance.
We trained a neural network drummer to improvise with human musicians and explored bidirectional communication between human and machine performers. Our results showed that communication from machine to human improves the human player's flow and the quality of the improvisation.
In this example, the system communicates with the human musician by means of an emoticon that represents different levels of confidence. The expression changes continuously in response to the confidence of the machine improviser, and sustained high levels of confidence result in a pulsating glow behind the emoticon in time with the beat. This work showed that this type of simple and interpretable communication increased the flow within the human AI collaboration, as well as the quality of the music produced. Co-creation, real-time interactions, and collaboration are important topics in the computational creativity community. However, the communication between computational creative systems and their users is still very limited to a few exchanges. Here, for instance, we have the recording of a live human-machine performance between a jazz musician and a real-time interactive music improviser system, and a conversation between the musician, the algorithm, designer, and a member of the audience about the performance. At some point of the recording, the human musician commented, "I think by this stage that I wanted the algorithm to come up with a new interaction mode." And a member of the audience replied, "In a human-human interaction, the musician being questioned would reply with a rationale about his or her decision. However, the system doesn't have a choice in this conversation. Instead, the system's designer tries to provide it himself as he replies. It has a kind of reset function that causes it to forget your patterns occasionally. Even though the system's designer tries to provide information about how the system operates, he's unable to provide an explanation of what exactly was going on at a specific point in the performance, as only the system knows the details of what went on at every point of it." We introduce here the concept of explainable computational creativity, which considers the need for bidirectional communication between people and machines a key element for a creative partnership, where the creative process is transparent as well as discussed. We believe that this would improve interactions, build up trust on computational creative systems, and encourage human engagement. Here is an inspiring example of our long-term vision of explainable computational creativity.
Can you help us design an advert for a toothpaste? The brand is Crest, the target audience is adults, and the product attributes include teeth, cavities, and decay.
How about this image?
I don't understand the picture. It doesn't look like it has anything to do with toothpaste.
Teeth and dice are similar in that they are normally white, shiny and cube-shaped. Dice are connected to gambling, which is connected to poker. I use domain shifting to get the idea that while you usually gamble with money, you can also gamble with other resources, including body parts, such as teeth. I use this to make the idea, what if someone gambled with their teeth instead of with money?
I understand now, but I still don't really like it. It's too big of a jump. The connection to toothpaste isn't obvious.
I think it's a good connection. There is a strong surface similarity between teeth and dice, and the two concepts are not normally associated, so it would be surprising. Also, the idea and image are somewhat repulsive, and repulsive adverts have a shock value which helps people to remember them. Other repulsive adverts have been quite effective. Have a look at this.
Possibly.
How about I invent the tagline to explain and support the image?
Okay.
In the domain, there is the notion of being able to afford money or not. Since the advert associates gambling with teeth instead of money, I have made the tagline, "There are some things you just can't afford to gamble with."
That is good. I like the tagline and you might have something there. I don't think the image is eye-catching enough, though. Could we do something else for the image? How about blending the two similar concepts to make dice teeth?
That is a good idea. Okay, I have made these two images. I prefer the second one because it is more repulsive.
I prefer the second one too, but it is too repulsive to put on an advert. Can you make it cleaner and also add multiple dice teeth?
I disagree that it's too repulsive, but I'll clean it up anyway. How about this?
I like the concept now, though the execution isn't very good. I will send to our artist and add the tagline and product information.
With this example, we'd want to emphasize that without the system explaining its ideas and pushing back a little, it is easy to imagine that a user may stop engaging after the first generative act, thus missing out on the concept. We have drawn from a range of research that looks at human collaboration, teamwork, cognitive science, and psychology, as well as from our own experience on the development of computational creative systems, to identify a set of four main design principles for explainable computational creativity. The first principle is mental models. Mental models are representations of key elements of the creative environment that help conceptualize, understand, and construct expectations of how things work and how individuals interact within a creative collaboration. Computational creative systems can use these representations not only to understand the operation of their co-creators, the environment, and the domain, but also to reason about them and seek different creative ways of interaction by questioning them. Shared mental models can increase both computational creative systems and users' awareness of processes within the collaboration, for instance, in order to achieve cognitive convergence when the goals of the collaborators do not match. In the inspiring example, for instance, the system can pick up from the explicit intervention that the user doesn't like ideas whose connections are not obvious and can adjust its mental model with this information in order to generate new ideas. The second principle is long-term memory, which is the capacity for storing and accessing information of past experiences and interactions. Being able to explain their decisions and support their ideas requires CC systems to have a memory of the processes, decisions, and interactions they have undertaken in current and previous collaborations. Equipping computational creative systems with this ability would enhance the creative capacity of their collaborations and will aid at breaking habits and avoiding repetition or mistakes. In the Spiring example, for instance, the system can review past experiences and find additional strategies to support its idea. In doing so, the system finds that in a previous interaction, another user used a tagline to clarify an abstract concept for an ad and suggest this to the user. The third principle is argumentation, which is the process of reasoning about and supporting specific contributions within a creative collaboration. The key aspect behind this principle is that a fruitful creative partnership enables participants to both explain and justify their ideas in order to unveil or clarify their creative value. An artifact may be of poor quality, but the process behind it novel and interesting. In the example, after the second interaction, when the system proposes the use of a tagline to clarify the image, the user is willing to give a chance to the system's idea, but she is still not sure about it. The system then supports this idea by looking for similar adverts that have been successful. The last principle is about exposing the creative process, which consists in opening up the environment and exposing the steps, assessments, metrics, influences, etc., that constitute the processes and decisions within the operation of a domain. Descriptions or clues envisaged for this purpose of explaining the underlying reasoning of a system may sometimes fall short. Opening up the environment and exposing the reasoning that constitute those processes and decisions would provide a clearer view of how a computational creative system works. We believe that observing, feeling, or in some way sensing the underlying structures of a computational creative system, instead of being told how things work, may trigger thought processes in the mind of their co-creators that may result in benefits for the creative collaboration. In the Spiring example, for instance, the system can expose its reasoning even further so that the advertising executive has a better understanding where the ideas come from. Imagine, for instance, the system in our Inspiring example has an interface that allows the user to investigate the underlying structures behind its ideas through the means of a visual graph representation of its knowledge base. By seeing the connections among the concepts in the knowledge base, the user realizes that the two related concepts, dice and teeth, are not actually directly connected, and sees this as an opportunity to improve the concept of the ad by blending the two concepts. The design principles shape the creative process in an explainable computational creative system. Relevant past experiences and the shared mental models are direct inputs to how the system operates, while the interactive process of argumentation together with past experiences help update and modify the mental models. The long-term memory is updated with new experiences of the creative process, and the operation of the system is exposed through different interfaces that allow the user to understand underlying procedures of how the system works. Instantiating these interactions depends on the creative domain, the stakeholders involved, and the stage of the creative process where the interventions occur. Also, communication in this broader sense should be considered not only linguistic forms. The form of communication should be appropriate to a creative task and information being communicated. In an improvised music performance, for example, it would be inappropriate for participants to stop playing and start talking about why one made a particular musical decision. Visual, sonic, haptic, or even olfactory communication may be the most suitable, such as in the example earlier when we showed the AI music improviser. Different issues surround the idea of explainable models. For instance, endangering the trust of co-creators, users, etc., by providing inaccurate representations of the functionality of the system. Although we believe that computational creativity provides an outlet in which explanations do not have to be faithful to functionality, to the functionality of a system, and has been postulated through the notion of framing in previous work, a computational creative system may endanger trust, for instance, by taking credit for other people's ideas. There is also a need for these systems to be socially responsible. For instance, one thing is for the computational creative advertiser in our example to refer to gambling as an analogy to endanger oral health. And another questionable possibility is to use it to encourage gambling. Finally, there must be clear limits about the extent of which a computational creative system may try to push an idea. A system cannot disrupt or take control over a creative process. Imagine, for instance, the computational creative advertiser in our example not backing down about using the first image of the poker table even though its co-creator had already rejected it. I have talked today about how interactions with computational creative systems require bidirectional communication channels that enable a more active partnership between systems and their users. We believe that this framework will benefit human-machine interactions by first enhancing their creativity as a result of working together rather than in isolation. Second, by creating more fruitful and productive partnerships, by establishing bidirectional communication channels where creative contributions can be examined. And third, by increasing the engagement of users with computational creative systems by improving the flow of these collaborations and the overall perception of their outcomes. The approach also opens up questions of future work, such as what makes a good or poor explanation in the context of computational creativity, how do we evaluate computational creative systems with explanatory capabilities, and many more questions that need to be studied in depth as explainability becomes a part of the development of computational creative systems. Thank you very much.